Hello, students. So we were seeing the properties of squares. In that, we are continuing with the some more properties of the squares. Just see here, a perfect square leaves a remainder of 0 or 1 when divided by 3. A perfect square leaves a remainder of 0 or 1 when divided by 3. Let's take an example. When we divide 16 by 3, it's 3, 5 is 15. So 3, 5 is 15, 5 is answer and remainder is 1. 36 divided by 3, which is your 12, 12, 3 is 36 and remainder is 0. Take another example, 9 divided by 3, which is your 3 and remainder is 0 here. Take another example. 25 divided by 3, which is 8 and remainder is 1. So this is the another properties by which we can find out which is the perfect square or not. Next properties is between the squares of any two conjugative number n and n plus 1, the number is n and n plus 1. There are 2n number which are not squares. So if you want to find out how many numbers are lying between that two squares, you can easily tell. So 2 ka square and 3 ka square, there are 2n numbers, that is your 2 into 2 which is 4, you can tell. And numbers are like 5, 6, 7 or 8. 5, 6, 7 and 8, not or, it's 5, 6, 7, 8. Take another example. 1 square and 2 square, which is 2 into 1, that is your 2 numbers and numbers are 2 and 3. We will take another example like 3 ka square and 4 ka square. So 3 into 2, that is to be number 6. So between 9 and 16, there will be 6 numbers. So which is your 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. These are the number which is not a square, children. Okay. So I think you might have understood the concept of the squares between two numbers. Okay. So just learn at home. Ghar pe seekho. Powered by bookmytutor.in. Thank you. Thanks for watching.